'Twas the night before Christmas, inside Luigi's laundromat. Not a creature was stirring, not even a rat. Can you believe it's Christmas already? This is among one of my favorite times of the year, besides autumn and my birthday. And because this is such a prominent time of the year, it means that plenty of movies and TV shows have been set during this time, whether they're directly related to Christmas, or if they're not, but the holidays are still clearly happening in the background. But what about in video games? There's games such as Bully, which have sections set during Christmas, but the events of the entire game don't take place around this time. But what games do? One of the first games that I think of when I think of games that are likely set during the holidays, or at least in the middle of winter in a holiday-ish environment, is Max Payne. The first time I ever played this game was in winter in 2011, and the weather outside my window almost perfectly matched the weather that this game had. It was really atmospheric to play in the winter. The winter storm that the game is set during is said to be one of the worst in the city's history, and this is the reason we see no civilians outside. Just Max, mobsters, and junkies wearing t-shirts out in the middle of winter. Now, for a long time, we didn't really know what month during winter that the game was set. It could be anywhere from late November to early March. All we know is that it's set in 2001. The PC version of the game does feature multiple shots of the World Trade Center, but this was only because the PC version was released in July of 2001. The game only arrived on consoles in December of that year, and by that time, all images of the Twin Towers had been removed from the game. If they left the Twin Towers in, you could argue that it's early 2001. But with the removal of the twins, it's gotta be set sometime in late 2001, right? I guess it all boils down to which version is actually canonical and which is just there as a product of its time, either for when the old World Trade Center was still there, or when companies were trying to avoid appearing insensitive or not wanting to remind audiences of 9/11. Of course, I highly doubt that someone like Max would ever be in the mood to celebrate Christmas, ever. There actually is one very minor reference to Christmas in Max Payne, but it doesn't necessarily mean it's in December.
I don't know about this.
Quit worrying, eh? Think of it as Christmas. The Russians, I was Santa.
Of course, if you decide that your personal headcanon places the events of the game as happening in December, then, you know, maybe it means something. I don't know. If I'm being totally honest, I started making this video because I could have sworn that the date that the first game took place was mentioned in the prologue comics released for Max Payne 3. But now that I'm looking at those, it doesn't say a thing about whether it's in December or not. I really don't know what I'm remembering that from. And I also don't want to rely on any fan wikis either, because the one for Max Payne mentions both early 2001 and December of 2001. This leaves me in kind of an awkward spot, because now I've got a Christmas video about a game that might not even be set in December. Oh well, let's just move on. Actually, before that, one more point I wanted to make about Max Payne. Why the hell is he dressed so late for a winter storm? Seriously, this is one thing I never understood about the game. It's literally the worst winter storm in the city's history, with freezing cold temperatures, snow and ice everywhere, and Max chooses to go outside wearing a t-shirt, an unbuttoned Hawaiian shirt, and a thin-looking leather jacket that's opened up. I guess they designed him to look cool over looking practical for a winter storm, but I felt like they could have at least given him like a puffy jacket with a fur-lined hood or something. I mean, he looks like he's freezing his ass off, no wonder he's making that face. Oh well, I guess it is what it is. But hey, I gotta say, that's a pretty cool looking Hawaiian shirt, and it's based on a real design that Sam Lake wore while posing for the graphic novel pictures. Wish I could get that for Christmas. Hey, if you want a classic game that was definitely set around this time, then look no further than Sega's old rail shooter, The House of the Dead. That was set on December 18th, 1998, a whole week before Christmas. Of course, there's no mention of the holiday anywhere, and I guess that makes sense for a zombie game, but if you wanted to take a look at other games set in this time of the year, Alien Isolation would probably be it. That game is likely set around December 11th, 2137, according to some in-game archive logs that detail certain in-game events. But in space, no one can hear you sing Christmas carols, and no one seems to really care about the holidays either. I can understand that. I mean, in this game's universe, people are basically put into a comatose state for anywhere from a few months to a few years while they're traveling through space. And as we've seen in most of the movies set in the Alien universe, whenever anybody wakes up from these things, they're usually not in the mood for anything besides throwing up and trying to figure out what the problem was that woke them up to begin with. I think only the characters in Prometheus cared enough that it was Christmas, but even that was still set in this century. Alien Isolation is in 2137, so by then, people who traveled through space probably just gave up on holidays altogether. And when a horrific monstrosity is trying to hunt you down and brutally kill you, or worse, then it's understandable that most of these people aren't going to want to really be thinking about how fun Christmas is. Now, last but not least, we've got Grand Theft Auto V. The game's snowy prologue is definitely set near Christmas in 2004. The month isn't mentioned at the start, but it becomes obvious as soon as you see the Christmas tree and other decorations inside the place that they're robbing. There's also a house with a Christmas tree inside of it. 9 years later, during the main story of the game in 2013, we get to return to North Yankton, and it's still snowy, and the Christmas tree is still there too. But does this mean that the main events of GTA 5 are happening in November and December? Or is the game set in early 2013 and the Christmas tree is there because they never bothered to remove it from the map? Because besides the fact that the time of day changed, there is really no other difference to North Yankton. I gotta say though, whether it's early 2013 or late 2013, it does make sense that the game is set in the winter. I mean, how else can it possibly rain as much as it does on a map that's based in the LA area if it isn't set during the rainy season in SoCal? And there you have it. My thoughts about games that might or might not be set near Christmas, and even when they are, almost none of them bring it up. I guess it's down to the irrelevancy of any sort of holiday to the game's plot, but it's something that was on my mind nonetheless that I wanted to talk about, so thanks for listening to my ramblings about it. In the meantime, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, Happy whatever you celebrate. Have a great time today and tomorrow, and I'll see you soon. Turn around, walk back home. Get a coat and a scarf. That would have been the smart thing to do. Guess I wasn't that smart.